There's also Louis Bouchard here with me in the front. So I'm really happy, we're really happy to be here to present something that is that might sound familiar to some of you, because we presented LightTwist, our multi-projector project, 2 years ago at LGM here. Anyway, so the project today is easy multi-projector desktop using LightTwist, Compiz plugin. So Compiz is pretty new, actually. So, well, a quick overview. So I'm not going to talk very long. I'm just going to remind you of what the LightTwist project is, and then mention Compiz, how do you align projectors, and then actually we'll do a live demo. Just a quick thanks. In our lab at the University of Montreal, just next door, in the computer science department, there are many students who work in computer vision. And so what you see here is a branch or a sidetrack of many of the work we do. And these are the students working on these projects. OK, so what is LightTwist? Well, it's a multi-projector immersion software that tries to allow you to project with many projectors on any surface you want. And the key of this system was that you don't align by hand. You use a camera, and the camera is going to take pictures of the screen and align everything automatically. And so if you were there 2 years ago, you saw a demo of a cylindrical screen. So that was done with LightTwist. Now, the key in a system like this is that you have up to, let's say, 12 projectors. And you need lots of machine, and they're synchronized by network. It's a pretty complicated setup. It's very nice, but it's complicated. So I would say the problem with that is that no one can actually use that very simply when they have few projectors. So the goal of today is to actually propose something a little bit different. So this is a reminder of the screen that we brought here 2 years ago. And it was pretty big, 5 meter, 7 projectors. It took quite a few people and a few hours to set up. So this is not the typical screen you set up in your living room to watch a movie. By the way, we are working, we have a version of this in our lab, which does also stereo projections. So you have stereo, cylindrical, immersive stereo projections. They're very nice, and they're also double the trouble, if you want. So some people here might recognize themselves. That was taken last year by Yuval Levy, actually here. It's hard to recognize people with the little square in their face, but anyway, that was inside the screen last year. Now, a word on Compiz. So our goal is to make multi-projection very, very simple. And we figured the only way to make this simple is to forget the requirement of having a player software that will play video and images and things like that. So the only way to do that is to actually distort the desktop itself. And the way to do this is to use Compiz on Linux. Works really well. So Compiz, if you don't know what it is, it's what makes all the window jiggle and all the fancy OpenGL effects on the desktop. And one thing that it does, that it can do very well, is to distort images. So we figured, actually, why not create a standard plugin that people can just put on their desktop that will help them align projectors. So that's the idea. And actually, this, once you have the plugin, becomes extremely simple to use. OK, so how does it work exactly? Well, you use this distortion plugin that you just enable, and then you need to create what is called a lookup table that will just take pixels from the screen and figure where they should come from the desktop, and do the selection of the pixels. And it comes in the form of an RGB image so that it's easy to look at, nice to look at too. It's a 16-bit PNG. And by the way, a word about the 16-bit PNG. If you want to edit the image, then you need to use Krita, which works really well. But I might have a feature request for that. Krita does not preserve the text tags in a PNG file, and we do hide a lot of information in the text tags of the PNG files, and it would be nice to be able to save them. Or maybe I'm wrong. Really? Oh, well, very good, because that's nice. Yes?
Because we use text PNG files to store rust presets.
Mm-hmm.
So we need that information also.
Oh. We store the brush presets in PNG files. We just rename it to KPP, and mm-hmm. we use that part of the file to store data. So we had the book, so we had to fix it.
Very good. So actually, this is a very nice addition, because in the PNG, we don't store that much information, but there's a little bit that's important. But anyway, otherwise, it's a standard image. And the red actually encodes the X coordinate, and the Y is encoded in the green image, and then the blue, it just encodes the blending that will be necessary between the projector. So it's very simple, works really well. by the way, the plugin we made for this is actually based on an excellent FBO plugin by Alexander Lang. I want to mention this. This is in compass.org. Now, how does it actually work? Well, it's very easy. That's a pixel on the screen, which means like on the projector. And to figure out what color you're going to put there, Compass will actually look in the lookup table in the red, the green, the blue. And with the red and green, we'll figure the position on the desktop and just pick that color and then multiply by the blue stuff to get the nice blending, and that's it. Okay? So it's very simple. There's no loss of... it's very efficient also. You do that for every screen or every projector. Mm-hmm. Now, how do you create the lookup table? Well, you could go to Krita and just draw one, but of course, it's not going to work really well. You need to align, and there are two ways. You can align by hand, or you can align using a camera automatically. Now, to make things simple for now, we propose that if you have two projectors, or maybe three, but basically if you have few projectors, you could try an alignment by hand, but you need a flat surface, like this one here is good. The projectors must be perfect, which means no radial distortion, but that's okay, actually. Most projectors are pretty good for that, because lines, you know, must look like lines. And then the projectors must, they must be overlapping, okay? If there's no overlap, it's very hard to align them by clicking on points. Anyway, you click on a few points, and then the projectors will be aligned. Okay, so our contribution here is the plugin first, but second, there's this little side program called LT Align that will make that part work for you. Okay, so you just click on a few points and it should work. So in practice, it's going to look like this, where this is two projectors that are overlapping, and you're going to have a couple points that you have to click on, and that's it. It's going to be all you need to get the distortion working. Now, one last word about what's next. Now, since the lookup table is an image, you can use different ways to create it. And so this is the simplest way. But if you happen to have a curved surface or weird projectors that are bouncing on curved mirror or all kinds of things, you can use a camera. And so we will provide a different program for using a camera. But they will generate the same lookup table, so it's going to be the same Compass plugin, so everything will work the same. Okay, that's pretty much where it's headed. Okay, now the LightTwist project right now is still working for big setup, but this is not something that is useful to that many people, because you need, you know, first of all, you need 7 or 8 HD projectors and lots of space. So we expect that this will be very practical to make, you know, most computers that have two video output to be able to do very simply multiple projections. So, yeah, for that you'll need a camera. Now, just to conclude what I had to say about this. So this is basically an attempt to make Linux multi-projection more accessible, easier to use, and it's really focused on simplicity. And, well, the website to get the information and the web page that describe the whole thing in detail is Vision3D. And that's pretty much it. And then we'll work on the webcam stuff later. Now, so this would conclude a little description, but maybe we'll try to do an actual demo. So let me just shut this down. Okay, and as Louis goes on to make this work, I'm going to try to describe what we're doing. Maybe I can, is it possible to lower the light? Okay. How about this? Okay. Now, what we have here is two HD projectors, so they're, 1920 by 1080 projectors. And you notice they are overlapping, and we've already set up the system so that it's, how do you say, you should start busy flag just for the heck of it. We did all this just to be able to play the tank game, busy flag, of course. That's our goal. As you can see, when you don't align projectors, you have a slight problem where you overlap. So anyway, we're going to try to fix this. So, there's not much point in playing right now, I guess, but anyway. So we'll try to align this for you and see how it goes. So the first step is to start the little aligner program, and it will light up each screen. And the most important thing here is that the overlapping of the two projectors is the key. You need overlap, and you go in the first screen and you click on 4 points just 4 points in the overlap. And then you go to the second screen, and by the way, the cursor will turn into a little X if you're not on the right screen. Yeah. And then you click again in the other screen, and now it's going to show up in green. Now, green on top of red should look yellow. So I guess if it looks yellow, then it's pretty much aligned. And your goal is to align the points, the red and the green, together. And you can move by a tiny fraction of a pixel using the cursor keys. It's very easy. And when you start to see yellow everywhere, then you're really happy. It means it's pretty much about to be aligned. Okay? Actually, this looks pretty good. Okay. And now the second step, the last step, is to define the whole screen area you want to use. So you just click on the 4 points that define your screen. Yeah. And this. And it will show you how the screen looks. Now it's up to you. If you want a perfectly square screen, well, just measure from the ceiling or whatever. But this is going to be your final screen. Okay? Yeah. You have to maximize every pixel, but that's pretty much it. Once you're done, you just, what is the key again? S. Yeah, the keys are not super sophisticated. So, S for save, and it's going to create the two lookup tables, and you're done with the alignment. That's it. Now, all that remains to be done is to get the Compass plugin working, and it's already working, right? Okay, now this is running Ubuntu 11.04, the latest, and we do have to restart Compass by hand to get the CCP flag going. It's a technical, yeah. We're still trying to figure that part. But basically, you restart Compass if it doesn't cooperate. And this is the option control of Compass, where you start and stop different plugins. And so the plugin is called Light Twist, so you just enable it. And then you have to give, in that plugin, the two lookup tables. And once it has the two lookup tables that you've created, then you just start the plugin. That's the first one. Well, there's a gamma parameter also. But we try to keep the number of parameter as low as possible, because it's a huge bother when you have 20 sliders to adjust things. Okay. I guess we're done. Are we done? Yeah. So when we're done, we just activate the plugin and just activate the distortion based on the lookup table. And yeah, and there you go. So now you have a screen, and yeah, so that's your new align screen. Yeah. Yeah, it does work. We've also added some anti-aliasing to be sure that even like a one pixel line actually gets distorted properly. So now, how about we play, let's play BZ Flag at last. Okay, so now, actually puts this game is a, this game was meant to be played on a huge screen, huge wide screen. So, I know we're following someone, right? So hopefully he's playing, but, yeah. Of course, we could probably follow some. Yeah. Get another server maybe. It should be fine. Yeah. By the way, most games, well, like BZ Flag is nice. It's going to go full screen instantly. But most programs, when you tell them to go full screen, they don't go full screen. They go full piece of a screen, which is not always great. But this is something you will notice. So anyway, I guess now you can play BZ Flag. Yeah. So I guess people are just not very active today on this BZ Flag. And I guess we won't start playing. Okay, but you get the idea for this. And this is an OpenGL game, so it works really well. Okay, let's show a couple more things that could be useful. What else? One thing that could be interesting, once you have a plugin like this, it means that every program suddenly becomes multi-projector. This means you can have a GIMP with a huge 4,000 image at 1-to-1 ratio and draw with really high detail in Inkscape or whatever, all these programs in Blender. And this is this is GIMP. As you notice, the tools are really small. But this is a, let's see, so I guess, this is going to be our image. Was it by, commence one? Okay, yeah, okay, so it should be bigger, but this still is it's a 3,000 something. And you will notice that although it's very well aligned, in the middle, you might notice a slight change of color. This is because the lamps of the projector are not in sync. They are not the same age. And also, there's a lot of tricks to align color perfectly. Okay, and this is something maybe we'll add, but we don't want to add too much burden. The first step is definitely alignment. And it shows only when you have white. So if you start with a black image, you're not too bothered. Now, what else? Oh, yeah, and movie playing is nice also, yeah. We have a couple examples. FF Play will go full screen on the whole display. So this is an example. It's a little clip of an HD movie. But as you can see, FF Play movie will just play right away and be really happy. And you can play as high resolution as you want. It's going to work. So this is a very nice way to get your home movie theater going. All you have to do is find a couple of projectors, and the rest is fine. By the way, the price of projectors is going down very, very quickly. So this is becoming an alternative. But we figured, you know, why not have that used for the computers? It's very nice, and you can have a lot of shells open at the same time. Did we have another? It's basically it. Any program works on there, but we did not install that many. Maybe a Stellarium is one. Yeah. Most people, you know Stellarium? That's the Sky, open source Sky Viewer program. And this one does not do full screen by itself. You have to actually make it really big. But what's nice here is that it's an actual Sky View, and you get the full resolution of the sky, and actually, it's, well, of course, now it's a little, it's not dark enough to really, oh, t'as un bouton? Yeah, click on the button right there. Come here and click on this, this and this and this, yeah, remove this stuff, yeah, this and this also. Yeah, this is a true night sky, but still, we have something lighting on. But as you can see, this is an OpenGL program, and it's the same. You get really high resolution now, so many programs become very, very fun to use. Yeah, actually very fun. Oh well. So, maybe I will just stop there and let Louis move around the stars and maybe answer a few questions if you have any questions. So, feel free to ask. Mm-hmm. Otherwise, well, I guess that's our demo. Oh, there's something else to mention. The code is, of course, available. So it's not available as packages and stuff like that yet. But still, you can download the tar files and compile that very, very simply. So it's something that should work right away on the... Oh, actually, yeah, you can go to a web page. It's very fun to browse at 4,000 pixel wide. Yeah. Yeah, so. Okay, so this is the web page for symmetry goals. Oops, no. plus. Yeah. By the way, YouTube, stuff like that, Flash, it all works. So, yeah. Anyway, so yeah, so it's on the page there. All the instructions are there. Lots of dependencies, but it does work. Mm-hmm. Yeah. So in the future, we hope maybe we could integrate that somewhere. Inside the compass package, for example, but we'll see. So anyway, so that's pretty much the presentation. So thank you very much. And mm-hmm. if you have any questions, well, feel free. Ah, ouais, j'ai fermé les lumières.
Actually, more of just quick comment rather than question, because I was just thinking about Lightwave or LightTwist and what it's done recently the other week, because I went through my big box store and they had nice projectors for $900,
mm-hmm.
home theater projectors, and then I went by my local Target store and on the clearance end cap they had a home gaming projector on clearance for $99.
Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm. So I was thinking, what could I do with that? Well, I guess I see now.
There you go. Mm-hmm. And by the way, of course, the most home computers have two, most graphic cards have two output, but you can buy also the video splitters like Matrox does one, and you can have two or three screens hooked up to your laptop. It's very feasible, and then it's very portable. So, but yeah, you're right. The projectors' prices are really going down. It's not a joke. It's really, really true. Mm-hmm.
Now, a question. I was thinking about what is the future like with GNOME 2 and the problem with GNOME 3 and Compiz is that it's not going to be continued. So are you thinking into like merging or migrating your plugin to something else? Or overclutter or something, so it can actually work on GNOME 3 and stuff, or because obviously we're going to move on and as future comes.
Well, that's a really, really good question.
Because it's an excellent functionality, and it would be really shame to lose it. If you're moving on in the future.
I think because it's kind of useful, it would be nice to have it integrated so it's pretty much seamless and you don't have to install anything. It should be natural to do this. And also, given that it's, I have to mention that having an open system like Linux makes it really easy to do that, but it's not that easy to do that on Windows or on macOS. So the question of what's the future with Compiz, I'm not sure, but one thing I'm pretty much sure is that OpenGL effects on top of Windows will be there one way or another. And I guess the plugin concept has really proven itself to be very useful. So as long as that stays there, we're going to be moving this into whatever environment becomes.
It's not that hard to rewrite for another.
You're right. It can be rewritten very easily, no problem. Yeah, we'll make sure it stays there.
One last question.
Mm-hmm.
I want to comment to this last statement. I think I'm also a maintainer of a Compiz plugin, an independent one. Compiz goes on Ubuntu in the Unity platform. And for independent plugins, it would be very useful to have one common format to write plugins, at least for one operating system.
Oh, that's very true.
This should cover KVim, Compiz, and Matter, of course.
Yes, yes. Well, yeah, if we can participate in that, I would be really glad. It's a lot of work to, yeah, because it's a lot of work to port these things to many different. Yeah, sure.
Well, it's okay. Thank you very much.
Well, thank you.